could also be based on a startup company. So for example, if there is a company in the United States who would like to start up a company here in Canada and then transfer the employee here into Canada, that would be considered an intercompany transferee. So what that means is the two organizations, the two companies don't have to necessarily be up and running. It could be a startup company. If it is a startup company, obviously the officers are going to highly scrutinize that application. And there's a few things that you need to be aware of as to what the officer looks at. So for the first thing is, generally the company must secure a physical premises. So not that it's mandatory, but that usually demonstrates to the officer when you have a physical office, a physical premises, it demonstrates that this is a serious application. That this isn't an application of convenience just so that the applicant gets status in Canada. So, particularly the case if you do the intercompany transferee under specialized knowledge, they really want to see that this application is serious and that this company is not just being created just so that the applicant can get status here in Canada. The other is the company must be furnished realistic plans to staff new operation. Meaning including a business plan into the application to show that the startup business does intend to hire Canadians and to expand its operations here in Canada will definitely increase the chances as well. Obviously, as any business, you can steer away from the business plan once the work permit is obtained, so long as there was the intent of complying with the business plan. The reason why I say this is because when the work permit expires and it comes up for renewal, you have to go back to the original business plan and explain to the officer what you did and what you didn't do. And whatever you didn't do, it has to be explained as to why it wasn't done as per the original business plan. The other is the company must have financial ability to commence business here in Canada and be able to compensate its employees. So obviously the foreign company, in my example, the US company, would have to show a budget for the Canadian company. So whatever the company is, depending on the size of the company, what the company is, and how many employees it intends to hire, in the business plan you want to include a financial budget for this organization, for this startup company. And usually I would recommend at least a 3-year plan when you include that business plan to say this is our budget, this is how we're going to advertise for it, this is what we intend to spend, and by this year we intend to hire this many Canadian employees for the organization. Also, when transferring executive and managers, the company must demonstrate it will have large enough support for that executive or managerial functions. So what I mean by that is, certain organizations are quite small. You might not need an executive or a managerial position to start that startup business. And usually it's just one or two specialized knowledge individuals that can come and run the business and start the business. So the budget as well as the organization size will demonstrate if the company will actually need an executive or a managerial position. So you want to be mindful of that. No matter what you do, you definitely want to include the business plan and outline everything from advertisement to how many employees you're going to hire, how many Americans are going to be transferred to start this business up, what the budget will be, how long it will take to run this business, and obviously demonstrate a bona fide intent that you're going to continue to grow the company in the US as well as in Canada. So if you're looking at doing a startup business here in Canada and possibly transferring the employees from the foreign company to Canada, give us a call and let us make sure that you have a thorough business plan fleshed out for the officer to review. If you have any questions about this, give us a call. We're here to help. Thank you, and until next time.